nickel is a nickel, says a dime is a dime. You want a good guy, maybe she won't mind. Tell me how long do I have to wait? Can I get you now? Must I hesitate? Eagle on a dollar said, in God we trust. She wants a good man, wants to see that dollar first. Tell me how long do I have to wait? Can I get you now? Say, must I hesitate? Whiskey was a river and I was a duck. Might swim down in the bottom, might never come up. Tell me how long do I have to wait? Can I get you now? Must I hesitate?
You want to sing another one?
Sure.
Let's do that, though. Sitting on top of the world.
All right. So I think for me, on a personal note, there was a time when I first started playing guitar, I only played electric guitar for first 10 years of playing and pursuing, learning music on the guitar. And But it was a time a band I was in kind of went away, and I really got into acoustic music. And I'd say Jorma's style and this kind of raggy sort of style of guitar, fingerpicking, and the alternate bass, you know. Really, I came to get interested in it through Hot Tuna, and then I found a lot of other artists back behind. You know, where Dave mentioned Rev Gary Davis, and then that leads you to, you know, Mississippi John Hurt and Big Bill Brunzi and Blind Boy Fuller and all these amazing guitar players, and Robert Johnson.
Blind Willie Johnson.
Blind
Willie McTell.
Right. Skip James, you know. Anyway, so it was... It was part of that digging back into the sort of the history, you know, that started for me when I realized, oh, you know, these guys didn't write all these songs. They didn't invent this stuff. They are carrying it forward and going back in the tradition. So anyway, they're also doing their own thing with it, you know. They're taking a traditional tune. Which this next tune, Sitting on Top of the World, you know, is a very old song. In fact, I don't really know who wrote it.
I think Bill Monroe played it, you know. It went through a lot of different changes. One of the great fingerstyle players of our time was a guy named Jerry Reed, and who sort of different style, but related nevertheless. And this is kind of, these are his chord changes for the tune, Sitting on Top of the World. But it's in a style of guitar playing that's sort of related, so we thought it would work. So we do our own thing. Sunny day, my good gal left me, you know she went away. As she's gone, 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 I don't worry, I'm sitting on top of the world. Mississippi River, deep and wide, my good gal left me, she's on the other side. As she's gone, 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 I don't worry, been sitting on top of the world. Ashes, dust to dust, find me a woman that a man can trust. She's gone, 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 I don't worry, been sitting on top of the world. Well, me up from El Paso, said come on baby, you know I miss you so. As she's gone, 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 I don't worry, been sitting on top of the world.
Mentioned John Hurt, and Mississippi John Hurt is one of those guys that did that same kind of Reverend Gary Davis, you know, bass line with a thumb and keep it moving. He was definitely among the influences on guys like Jorma and other fingerstyle players like Leo Kaki that came along. This one's been done in different ways by different people, and it's called the Spike Driver's Blues. Like a man, steal like a man, steal like a man, steal like a man. John Henry, he left his hammer side of the road, side of the road, side of the road. Take this hammer and carry it to my captain. Oh, tell him I'm gone, tell him I'm gone. Tell him I'm gone, all the way to the High Sierra Mountains. That's my home, that's my home, that's my home, that's my home. Take me home, Lebo. You all know the Jorma tune, Embryonic Journey. You guys know that one? So that's not really fair. It's not really technically the roots of Hot Tuna because actually he wrote it. But all is fair in love and war and music festivals, so. But to give it a little twist, we want to just like give you a taste of that. And then there's a traditional song called The Water Is Wide. Not to be confused, yeah. Not to be confused with Jorma's water song, but the two kind of go nicely together, so we'll lay this one on you. So this is like an embryonic journey to the wide water. Thank you. Can't tell you how nice it is to sit up here between these two guitar players and just listen. It's pretty awesome. These guys are like the stars of the festival. I mean, there's a lot of amazing musicians at High Sierra, but they're everywhere, playing in every setting. And a couple of my favorite people and musical heroes up here. I love these guys. And I know a lot of you feel the same, so I'm preaching to the choir. All right, another guy that probably was influenced by a lot of the same music and was sort of a contemporary of Jorma's but was a much older guy, was a beautiful, beautiful man named Doc Watson. I'd say one of my favorite Doc Watson albums is the one that he did with his son, Richard Watson, otherwise known as Merle, namesake of the Merle Fest. And they played beautifully together. And this one is one from that record of the called Third Generation Blues.
And Merle was named for Merle Travis. Yeah, right. One of the king daddies of all of this.
King daddies.
Style of guitar.
You
want to
count it?
Georgia, Lord, I'm wishing I was back in Tennessee, way down in that old Columbus stockade. My friends have all turned their backs on me. Go and leave me if you wish to. Never let me cross your mind in your heart. You love another. Darling, I don't mind.
Take it, Scott.
I was mistaken, Lord,
across your mind and your heart. You love another. Leave me, little darling, I don't mind. Leave me, little darling, I don't mind.
One more time.
Oh, Columbus Stockade Blue. Death don't have no mercy in this land. Death will leave you standing crying in this land. Won't come to your house, Lord, it won't take long. Look and find your brothers and your sisters are gone. I said death don't have no mercy in this land. Show me your mercies.
Thank you.
standing crying, oh, in this land. Well, I come to your house and it won't stay long. You look in the morning, your brothers and sisters will be gone. Death don't have no mercy in this land. I said, death don't have no mercy in this land. One more time. I said, death don't have no mercy in this land.
Lebo. Sweet.
Sweet song about death.
Yeah. It's always good to sing about death in the middle of the day, you know. It's hot out there. Got to remind yourself.
Yeah. Awesome.
Last year we did this and a play shop and Oliver Wood joined us and he actually did that tune. And I don't know if you guys know the Wood Brothers, but that was a wonderful experience.
I was inspired by it.
Yeah. It was very inspirational. I keep on praying for this old world will soon be done. You gotta keep your land trimmed and burning. Keep your land. Keep your land trimmed and burning. For this old world will soon be done. Take it, Lebo.
I want to thank Bo Carper for playing the guitar with us.
Yeah, absolutely.
And studying up on all this guitar playing, and also I love Bo in this. You know, this little band has a name. This band is called One Big Guitar. And that's the concept, you know, we try to get everything rolling into one big guitar sound. So we lose ourselves as individuals and just become one thing. That's the goal. But one of the reasons, too, that we really love Bo is that he does most of the talking.
And most of the set list planning, too.
Yes, he does it all. Zion's playing great. So thanks, Bo.
And I have one more thing to say.
Actually, I will say one thing about Bo is that I actually was first turned on to all the country blues styles through Bo, actually. Because we had our rock and roll bands, and we play so many festivals together. And Bo was always on the side showing me Mississippi John Hurt and the like. And so it's great. It's fun to have this group here. And really, it's all through him showing me that music. So more love for Bo.
Thank you, Lebo. Yeah. Yeah, we've done a bunch of shows together with New Monsoon and ALO together out on tour. And Michael Pollock here is mixing the show. Actually, we met in Minnesota on tour like 10 years ago. So it's been a nice long journey, and a lot of us came together at High Sierra originally. So this is one that's kind of in the vein of Jorma, and it was actually written by a guy named Leo Kaki. He's a great fingerstyle guitarist. Cool. Awesome.
All right, cool.
Have a nice stock.
Yeah. Nice, guys.
I like how we'll turn that funny note.
Yes. We want to do, you can lead it.
Yeah, let's do Boats Up River.
Okay,
cool.
What's that one called? Fishing Blues?
Fisherman.
Okay. All right, that tune was called The Fisherman, and we'll do another maritime song here.
We're actually going to perform the Rhyme of the Ancient Mariner first.
This is a tune by a guitar player who's since died a few years ago. His name is John Jackson.
Sorry.
And he used to go up to to Blues Week up in Port Townsend, Washington. My friend Orville Johnson met him up there, and he was about in his 80s, I think. He's from back east, and he taught my friend Orville a lot of stuff, or Orville picked up a lot from him, and this was a tune that I particularly enjoyed and learned. It's called Boats Up River. Boats up river won't come down. Bless my soul, babe, I'm waterbound. Ain't that a shame? I am to blame. And I wonder if my baby's on that train. Boats up river won't come down. Bless my soul, babe, I'm waterbound. Ain't that a shame? Wonder if my baby's on that train. I won't leave this old country. I'm gonna leave it all alone. Ain't that a shame? And I wonder if my baby's on that train.
We'll do another one in that sort of ragtime vein, which was a thing that Hot Tuna pulled together a lot. I heard him do a cool version of That'll Never Happen No More, the Blind Willie McTell song. This is kind of in that vein. It's another maritime song, actually. Yeah. Let the mermaids flirt with me. Body out in the sea, you can save all the undertaker's bills. Let the mermaids flirt with me. I do not work for pleasure, earthly peace I'll see no more. The only reason I work at all is to drive the world from my door. When my earthly trials are over, cast my body out in the sea. You can save all the undertaker's bills. Let the mermaids flirt with me. Take a voice. Forsaken me, and if I see her face again, I'll swim out across the sea. When my earthly trials are over, cast my body out in the sea, and you can save all the undertaker's bills. Let the mermaids flirt with me, and you can save all the undertaker's bills. Let the mermaids flirt with me. We're going to cheat a little bit on this one. You guys don't tell anybody, okay? This one has a similar kind of bass line to the Columbus Stockade Blues. So that's how I get away with it. We're going to sort of dig into a more contemporary tune, an instrumental version that I learned from a Chet Atkins and Lenny Bro record. So Chet Atkins is another great guitarist you guys have all heard of. And there's a guy named Lenny Bro, who was much less famous, but incredibly well-respected by guitarists throughout his life, his short life. Lenny was amazing. He did a duet record with Chet. And they covered all these horrible pop tunes that you would have hated to hear on the radio. But they're so good, the way they did them, that it's like the favorite song you've ever heard, right? I mean, the corniest, most terriblest songs, that if I read you the lyrics, you would blush. They would be embarrassing. But instrumentally, in the hands of those guys, it was kind of magical. So We'll lay this one on you. It's called Somebody's Knocking. Girls, where are their parents? These festival parents put their kids on stage, raising them like wild things. I'm gonna have a talk with her dad. got one more for you.
You can sing along if you feel like it.
guys so much. Scott Law, Lebo, I'm Bo Carper. Thank you guys.
Yeah, we'll see y'all later on.
Yeah, how about it, folks? One more time. Scott Law, Bo Carper, and Lebo. Thank you, guys.